Hey guys, this is Josh here with Trillium Wild Edibles. I'm out here doing a little hike today, doing a little bit of scouting. The plant that you see in front of you is cut leaf toothwort. There are a couple ways that you can tell this. First and foremost, you'll notice these white flowers with four petals. The petals are kind of long, as you can see here. Cut leaf toothwort has a palmate leaf structure. As you'll notice here, the leaves are kind of like a palm. The reason it's called cut leaf toothwort is because the leaves are very deeply cut, just like you can see here. And you'll also notice that the leaves have these little bitty teeth on them. And whenever you look at the leaves, you're going to notice three leaflets. It looks like there's five, maybe even seven. However, there's actually only three. You've got this middle one, and then you've got these two ends. If you look carefully around anywhere you find cut leaf toothwort, you're probably going to be finding more. The reason for that is it's a colonizing plant. A lot of the early spring wild edibles and plants in general are colonizing. And here next to this cut leaf toothwort, you can see some more spring beauties. Here on these flowers, you'll notice these little stripes, which you may not have seen in the other spring beauty. There are some slight variations in the flowers of spring beauty, just like there are some variations within most plants. Cut leaf toothwort is edible. It's the root that you're after, or the rhizome, which you can see this rhizome here. I'm not going to tear this plant up. However, you can see it right there. They're very, very shallow, so that's really nice. You don't usually need a trowel to even get to these, and you don't really need too much. You can take this little bitty rhizome here, and you can actually crush it up, and you can use it as a horseradish substitute if you really want to. It tastes delicious, and it tastes just like horseradish. It's got a good, mild, spicy flavor. It's very delicious, very juicy. And like I said, it really only takes a couple to make a decent amount of horseradish for a couple number of people. So you really won't have to do a whole lot of work to get to these. But I thought I would show you this. But there you may be able to see how much dirt I had to remove. I didn't really have to remove a lot. So this is kind of nice, and these are one plant that doesn't take a lot of work to get to. However, you're not going to get a lot of calories from it either, so it's kind of a give and take relationship. Cover this back up with its layer of soil and humus here and leaves. Now I'm going to go about my way. I thought that was kind of cool, and I thought I'd show it to you guys as well.